Americano, working like a Mexicano. New persona, we're moving off of Ferragamo. Get the llama, I party with the real Madonna. Beat the odds, do numbers, and remain humble. Tap, 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 punches, I'm so used to this.
Shorty.
Man, Weezy, that's the way.
What's poppin', fam? Welcome back to the vlog. Hope you guys had a great and productive week. If you're new to the channel, my name is Danté. I'm a 22-year-old footballer from the Virgin Islands who's aspiring to play professionally. In my vlogs, I'm basically documenting my journey into becoming a pro. So whether that be training at the field or in the gym, or just talking about my personal likes and interests off the field aside from football, I want to document it and just broadcast it to you guys. So without wasting any more time, let's just get right into it. So with me today is one of my teammates, his name's Ray J, and what we did was a gym workout based on our heart rates. As you can see right now, I'm constantly looking down, but I'm just trying to make sure that the heart rate monitor on my watch is working and that I'm gradually increasing my heart rate as we go through the run. This is probably one of the most intense start-stop workout that I've ever had, just because the trainer that gave us this workout plan told us that he did not want us to jog at the beginning. He wanted us to have a hard pace run in order to get our heart rates up to about 170 to 180 beats per minute. So that was pretty much our goal while doing this run. And as we got more into the run, we gradually increased the speed on the treadmill to where we were going to about a sprint. So we ended at about 11 to 12 miles per hour. Just to make sure that our heart rates were definitely at the benchmark that the trainer wanted us to be at. Alright, now I think I'm gonna fast forward through this part of the workout. Getting into the weighted part of the workout, me and Ray J did three sets of 20 goblet squats with a 25-pound plate. With this exercise, our main focus was form, being that our bodies were already at a state of fatigue. If you take a look at my footing, you can see that my heels are starting to rise and that they are starting to cave inward. So this just comes with fatigue. As my body gets more tired, I start to overcompensate in different areas of my body just to make the exercise a bit more easier and bearable. So as I do these exercises more often, then I'm gonna get more comfortable and my body isn't gonna have to depend on other parts in order to get through the exercise. The third part of our workout was three sets of 15 box jumps. Being that box jumps are a power-focused exercise, we just wanted to make sure that we're exerting enough or even more power into the floor in order for our bodies to be well above the box.
Oh no, I hope I don't fall.
For the last weighted exercise of the workout, we did lunges for three sets of 15 each leg. The split lunges, we did a core circuit that consisted of 50 crunches, 50 leg raises, and 50 Russian twists.
as we're about to go into Russian twist, my camera dies. Fortunately, I had my phone on me, so we were able to capture the last part of the workout, which was another 15-minute run. Alright guys, going straight from the gym to the field, I have training with me, my friend Tito. What we did in the beginning of this session was a dynamic warm-up, just making sure that our bodies were nice and warm in order to get into the session. And then we jumped straight into a very basic dynamic warm-up, where we did two touch and one touch passing, and then a couple volley variations. Here was our last technical warm-up. What we did was pass the ball 5 times in the middle and then push the ball to the outside with the inside of your foot and then back inside with the outside of your foot. So as you can see right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, outside, inside, and then pass back. And we did this for about 5 times each foot. Alright, this was our first working set. So the person passing the ball, which in this case is Tito, he calls a color, calls blue, I make a pass to him, then back up, take a touch inside the box, pass it back to him, and make 3 passes around the opposite cone, and then come back to the middle. So we're gonna do it one more time, just so you guys get a gist of it. He's gonna call red. He passed red to the wrong side of the cone, so we reset it, and then he's gonna do it again. He's gonna call red. I go back pedal, take a touch inside the box, then cut across to the opposite side, make 3 passes around the cone, and then we reset. And then for this drill, we did it for about 5 reps, and then we repeated it for 2 sets. Yeah. This second drill worked on our reaction time as well as our first touch into space. The passer would call one color and I would react to it. And then the second color that he called is where I would take my first touch into space to. So just to give an example, the first color he called is blue. I react to blue, take my touch towards orange, which is the second color he called. And also with the cones that were behind us, so yellow and blue, we made an extra effort to make sure that we touched the ball in front of the cone and then moved our body behind the cone and then make the pass back. Now this drill that we worked on was a two-way finishing drill where we worked on our ability to finish on a breakaway and also from the edge of the box. With this drill, the passer dictates the play. So the passer is gonna call red, I go to red, and then I back up. He plays a ball in between the lines and I try to finish far post. And then I quickly try to receive the ball on my back foot and then finish far post with my opposite foot. Last drill of the session, which was two-part finishing. For the first variation, I make a pass and let the ball go across my body and finish. Then with the second variation, I make a pass, touch the ball inside, then out, and then finish towards goal. We did this for 6 shots, so 3 of each variation, and we did 2 sets on each side. Guys, as we get into the end of the session, it's also the end of the video. I just want to thank you guys for all the love, support, and comments you left down below. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one.